You, come here. Okay, now imagine this scenario. You've been working tirelessly for God knows how long. So long you may have run out of fingers when counting the minutes, and so you decide to take a small breather. Something to cleanse the mind by rotting itself with short-form content or some other internet dumbassery. Just enough to rest your weary soul for like, I don't know, 2 hours at the very least. But there's always random people roaming around, definitely not minding their own business like they're supposed to. And if even one catches a glimpse of you browsing something like Reddit, it will end up being just like a parent walking into their kid's room just as the poor bastard decides to watch a YouTube video after he'd been doing his homework for the past 5 hours. And so now the parent thinks the kid's been slacking off all this time. Yeah. You certainly don't want to be on the receiving end of that. And so, I came up with the idea of creating a little helper in disguising our dissociative escapades. Namely, creating an extension that would allow me to toggle between the classic Reddit interface and that of Microsoft Outlook. It just so happened I picked these two as the central figures, but I think the video should help in creating similar pairings, as I have covered pretty much all the important aspects of such a task. Also, I forced myself to finish it in 3 days because why not? I figured this day would be reserved to documenting myself and setting stuff up. And so, the first step was to look up how to actually make an extension, because surely it can be as easy as copying a basic manifest file from the Chrome dev site, adding a simple HTML for the pop-up, and then loading it into the browser by the press of a button. Right? Right? Okay, now on to setting up the workflow and all the boring tidbits. But first, I want to explain my approach to this entire thing so that the struggles that I voluntarily put myself through will at least have some backing arguments. The idea is that the extension has two main parts, a pop-up and a content script. The pop-up is gonna be simplistic, only having a toggle button so that the user can easily turn it on or off dynamically. So, with some HTML, CSS, and a sprinkle of JS, bada bing, bada boom, pop-up's done. Now, the content script, on the other hand, is a bit girthier. The idea is that it mimics the Outlook webpage, placing it above all Reddit webpage elements, this being the static, never-changing part, and also hydrates itself with the dynamic data loaded into the normal Reddit website, this being the meaty part. For this, I felt using a framework was the way to go. In the end, all of these parts are managed in accordance to what is specified in the manifest.json file. Things such as knowing where each source file is located, as well as details regarding them, like, for example, opting to call the script when the page is loaded as opposed to before. Now, back to the setup. Also, don't worry, this was just a rough overview. I'll go into detail as the video progresses. Having worked with it recently and enjoying it quite a bit, I opted for Svelte as the big bad boy that's gonna do the heavy lifting. And normally, it's an incredibly easy to use tool. Normally. See, the thing is, the content script is just that, a script triggered at a specified time, whereas a framework produces an entire app, entry point being something like an HTML, for example. But in this case, I don't want to create a new HTML, and I certainly don't want to modify the existing one structure, as I'd rather keep my sanity levels in check. So, I had to come up with something that would take the app created by Svelte and initialize it as the script is called. After a bit of brainstorming, I came up with the idea of bundling the app into a single JS file, opting for a rollup, and as the entry point of the app, I chose the main component, as opposed to an entire page, as that proved to be a lot quirkier, so to say, and I'd advise against it if using Svelte at least. But what do you mean by quirky, you may ask? Well, as I said, I want the app to be instantiated as the content script is called, and because this won't be done by the framework, I need a reference to the app or content in order to instantiate it. And how does one get such a reference? Because all JavaScript frameworks are still JavaScript in most cases, I was able to access the main component by simply importing it from the Svelte file, and then instantiating by providing some parameters, namely a target, which is in general a DOM node to which the component will attach itself, as well as some props if need be. In this case, I set the target to be a div node inserted as a child to the body node of the document. With all this instantiating mumbo-jumbo done in a smartly named main.js file, I used that as the entry point in the rollup config and gave it a go. And guess what? It worked! On like the 10th try, cause I'm dumb and skipped on reading the documentation. But hey, works. Kinda. You see, I really like to put myself through hell for every extra inch of comfort. I also wanted to use a CSS when writing the styles, which, although looks easy at first glance, you just install a dependency, then add it to the suggestively named plugins list of the config. It took me like 30 minutes to figure out properly. But hey, it works. With this, the entire workflow is pretty much set. The bundle and the app are simultaneously built and hot reloaded so that I can work on the graphics in a separate tab, then just look at the changes in the extension by simply refreshing it in a browser. Totally worth the 4 hours of work. To get my confidence back after that fiasco, I thought I'd finish the day by working on the static part of the overlay. It worked pretty well, save for the fact I may kinda perhaps don't like front-end work, perchance. And also I had to import an external script to use Microsoft icons. On day 2 I put on my working overalls, and I became quite the productive little fella, managing to finish up the entire static layout as I was basically just recreating the website's elements exclusively in a visual manner, seeing no reason in adding any more functionality beyond reactivity on mouse hovers. Also, to be able to access the exact colors and even copy them from the computed style sheets when inspecting the official page, I created a global.css file in which I copied the CSS variables used by the project, as well as setting the font families to those used by the Outlook page. Of course, the work wasn't perfect, and I'm not talking about pixel differences on some positions. More like discovering that some icons were not present on the official Microsoft developer website, so I ended up using some that looked similar enough so that an untrained eye wouldn't notice the differences. And to be fair, if someone like your boss would see through that, you gotta give the man props, right? Also, if we're giving props, why not consider giving me some props with a tiny little click of your delicate mouse on that red subscribe button? And then I went and created the toggling mechanism by allowing the pop-up and the content script to communicate by reading a browser variable using the chrome.storage namespace, which can be easily swapped for the browser.storage one depending on the browser. And with this, the overlay was being successfully toggled on and off by using a svelte store binded to the value of the extension status. Whenever its value changes, the overlay component is re-rendered and the underlaid elements are updated. But then, it was finally time to get on with the juicy, succulent part, transforming the live feed of Reddit posts into a live list of emails. To get this to work, there were three main things that needed to be handled. Firstly, obtaining the data, which required going through the document of the Reddit page and analyzing the contents for common elements and reoccurring patterns in order to parse the DOM tree and only get the information I needed. Secondly, managing scrolling and loading new posts was a priority so that the live feed part was undead shortly after arrival, thus the creation of new entries in the DOM tree had to be noticed and handled accordingly. Lastly, all this information had to be transformed into legit passing emails, as well as tying together the UI of the extension and that of the Reddit webpage, mainly the scrolling part. The next couple of hours were spent analyzing and compiling connections between information I needed and its location in the HTML file, both as an authenticated user as well as an anonymous one, because for some reason the entire structure is different between the two. A truly thrilling process, but at least I didn't have to return to it once it was done, and that's a big win in my book. To finish the day, I decided to look into how to handle custom events, which eventually turned to using a mutation observer, as it was much easier to use, and maybe also the intended way for such tasks, I guess. Thus, now knowing when the user scrolled the page, resulting in prompting to create and populate new posts. I began the final day in full force. First, I created a template for the email previews in the list, which I decided would contain the title and the subreddit. I also thought I could get the date, but that turned out to be sucky and wouldn't want to work no matter what, as I couldn't get the raw timestamp, only the pre-formatted string, which would vary from something like X hours ago to normal date format, so I may have kinda dropped it. But it can still be seen when opening the post, so no biggie in the end. Then use the callback I provided to the mutation observer to append items to the list as they are created. Also, in order to sync the scrolling between the list and the Reddit webpage so that you may toggle the extension on and off and find yourself in similar positions, I used helper functions to take the scroll state from the list, convert it into a percent, and apply that percent to the scroll bar of the web page. And now, when scrolling the list, you also scroll the web page and load new posts. Next, I went on to mimic the look of an open email, deciding to use the subreddit logo as the sender image, setting the sender as the subreddit, which you can click to navigate to it, as well as the time information about when it was created. In the end, I opted for mimicking an expand content button in order to open the post page in an iframe, as that prevents any wacky behavior that may arise from Reddit and their post models. And well, that's it. Yeah, pretty anticlimactic, I guess. Wait, did you actually believe me? Of course it's not over. The icons were still yucky and also apparently didn't work in incognito. Regarding the second part, I thought it had something to do with my coding or maybe Chrome's incognito in general. Turns out the new manifest version 3 simply doesn't allow for calling external scripts anywhere in the extension. Which, fair, there would definitely be security concerns. But come on, I'm linking an official Microsoft URL, it's not some indie company. This whole thing meant I had to either copy the entire Microsoft document and host it with the extension, which, beside being a bad idea, it wouldn't even work properly. Of course I tried it, who do you take me for? Or going and using SVGs instead of icons. With a heavy heart and a level of disgust I never knew I could achieve, I started looking for accurate and up-to-date SVGs. And when I tell you it's easier to find a bar of soap at a convention than an SVG newer than 2003 for a Microsoft app, but out of thin air, like an angel descending onto earth to bless a poor soul with hope of eternal happiness, I came across a thread discussing exactly my issue. I then laid my despairing eyes upon a comment linking what I could only think of as the Holy Grail, a website containing the latest Fluent UI icons in various formats. All I had to do next was take the SVGs, replace the icons with them, then slightly modify the CSS, and done. Now, for real, it's done. Looking back, I would say this project was actually worth it, as I managed to learn quite a bit about this side of development, as well as understand some more of the witchcraft that is web dev, and I would even dare say it turned out pretty great, something I would actually use. Also, if I had the knowledge I have now after finishing it, hopefully equivalent to what this video offers, it wouldn't take more than a couple of hours to create something that would help you cheat the system out of free entertainment like the righteous person you are.